Normally, I do not do reactions to playoff ranking shows, especially the first one, because in a normal season, the playoff rankings show first week doesn't matter that much because whoever's in the top four usually doesn't stay there. Like you see, at the end of the year, sometimes you have two to three different teams. One of them usually makes it. They even talked about tonight where the number one seed tends to remain there more times than not, and the number three seed week one has never made it. And that's bad news if you're Clemson, if that trend continues. More on that later. But what I wanted to see tonight, where were the group of five teams, and I put BYU in that category as well. They're an independent, but they might as well be group of five. Where were the Pac-12 teams? Where were some of the one loss teams or the two loss teams and so forth? And what we got was fairly interesting. BYU is ranked number 14, and some people on the internet are upset saying they deserve a shot, and God bless them. When you play a bunch of garbage teams on your schedule, not completely their fault, but if you look at their schedule, we're honest with ourselves. Being undefeated with that schedule, OU would be undefeated with that schedule. I think everybody in the top 10 for the most part would be undefeated with that schedule. So, with that being said, Pac-12 teams, the highest ranked one is Oregon at 15. It's not looking good for the Pac-12. When you have more and more cancellations happening, I'm not liking the Pac-12 chance, the Pac-12's chances. USC is a team I was kind of keeping an eye on. Oregon, maybe it's different if they play each other. I don't know. But it's not looking good. So if you were worried about Coastal Carolina and Marshall, no, there's nothing to worry about. There was one team I wasn't wanting to see. It was Cincinnati. And they were, this is the highest a quote unquote group of five school has been in the playoff era. Believe it or not, number seven, Cincinnati. That's pretty high. So things work, fall the right way. They might have a shot. It's something to keep in mind. But where would Oklahoma fall? And in the AP poll, they were ranked 14. And I said to myself, if they're anywhere close to the top 10, all of a sudden, we got a shot. We have a shot. Is it the best shot in the world? No. Is there a path for Oklahoma to get to the top four? Yes. Do they need help? Yes. But the help, it's not really going to be that complicated. Whenever I look at these playoff scenarios, and I've done this every year for Oklahoma, and there's always, and let's be, Oklahoma's never gone in undefeated. So they've always had a loss to deal with. But this year they have two. But there's different circumstances this time. And and everyone's been writing off the Big 12. Everyone writ off Oklahoma. It was like once, like, everyone had a loss in the Big 12. Oh, Big 12's done. Because we all went to the beginning of the year and said, oh, Kansas State lost to, Arkansas State, and Iowa State lost to Louisiana, and Kansas lost to Coastal. Kansas is terrible every year, so I don't know why you're judging the Big 12 by Kansas. But everyone's like, oh, the Big 12 is written off. All of a sudden, about 4 weeks to go, it's not out of the question for Oklahoma to move up seven spots from 11 to 4. And I'll tell you why. It's very, very simple. You want Alabama, Notre Dame, and Ohio State to win out, run the table. You want Bama to win the SEC. You want Notre Dame, for the first time in the history of the sport, to win a conference. And you want Ohio State to just win. Did Ohio State look great at the end of the game when it came to, Indiana? No, but guess what? As of right now, OU is ranked ahead of Indiana. Shows how much they care about how the committee looks at Indiana right now. So if you look at the teams that are ranked above Oklahoma, you have Miami, Georgia, Northwestern, Cincinnati, Florida, and Texas A&M. Florida has of those teams, Florida has the most legit chance that's not projected to win a conference to win because they went out, they go toe-to-toe with Bama, and they beat Bama. Florida's in. And Florida, Kyle Trask, Heisman Trophy front runner, great offense, defense is not so great. But neither is Bama. And Bama lost a really key weapon in Jalen Waddle this year. So the SEC championship game looks to be interesting. Now, could some of these teams in the top four lose that would help out? Sure. Bama could potentially lose to Auburn. I mean, it sounds silly, but it's possible. Notre Dame could lose to North Carolina this week. Clemson could drop a game again. You know, if Clemson drops another game, they're in trouble. Because they might even make the conference championship, so they got to be careful. Ohio State looks a little vulnerable. They lost a lot of key pieces last year. But anyway, I know Texas A&M is one of those wild cards that people point out. I don't believe in Texas A&M, frankly, and think they will drop a game. I think they're losing to either LSU. Yes, you heard me right. I think they're going to drop to LSU or Auburn. They're going to drop one of those games. Tennessee, not so much. But Texas A&M's in a weird spot because they got their butts whipped by Alabama, and they don't have a path to play in the conference championship game. So that hurts. And yes, they beat Florida. They barely beat Florida. And that's a big win for them. That's why they're currently ranked ahead of them. Issue is, Florida's going to have a chance at Bama. And if Florida wins, they're going to be in. So then you have the problem of, do you bump A&M up? Do you keep Bama in? If there's a spot available, who do you take? I think I'd put in Alabama. Because it all depends how... It's not just losing, it's how did you lose. And that brings me back to Oklahoma, because I keep hearing, or the argument you will hear, they lost to Kansas State, lost to Iowa State. Kansas State is a bad loss, guys. There's no getting around it. Did Kansas State have a much better quarterback at the beginning of the year that got hurt and is out, and it makes things look worse? Absolutely. Fact is, they blew a 21-point lead at home, and it sucks. They should have won that game. If they would have won that game, Oklahoma would be right there in the 5-6-7 range. Probably 5-6-7 range is exactly. They would be above Cincinnati, in my opinion. So that's where Oklahoma's at. They need a little bit of help. But of all the teams above them, most of them have little to no chance of winning a conference. Oklahoma does. And here's where the path comes. Iowa State, ranked 13th, two spots below you. I know you have a beef. It makes sense. But if the roles were switched, I wouldn't care because I would still be optimistic for what lies ahead. If Iowa State wins out, Oklahoma wins out, they will more than likely play for the conference title. I know there's like a handful of scenarios where even if OU wins out, there's like two or three scenarios where OU could win out and not make it. It's very, very slim. I think if K-State loses another game, it's irrelevant. So because it goes to these weird tiebreakers. But let's just for argument say, if certain teams lose, I think Oklahoma and Iowa State is potentially a top 10 matchup in about 3 to 4 weeks. I do. I really do. On the 19th of December. So, with that being said, it's going to be very similar to Baylor last year. Baylor, the Big 12 championship game, where both whoever won that game was more likely going to the playoff. And that could be a very similar scenario. Because, like I said, Florida's going to drop. If they get to the SEC, I think Bama's going to beat them. That's just my opinion. A&M's kind of stuck, and I think they're going to lose another game at some point. Northwestern, all due respect, you ain't being Ohio State. If you do, more power to you. I'll apologize later. Georgia almost lost to an undermanned Mississippi State team. So I think at some point, OU's just going to jump them anyway if they keep winning. But that's the other thing. Winning games is not necessarily enough for Oklahoma. What Oklahoma needs to do is to keep doing what they're doing. Because I think one of the reasons they are where they're at right now is because the argument you can make is that they are a different football team with Ramondre Stevenson at running back and Ronnie Perkins on that D-line. You can't deny that right now. This is a different football team. And you could, and for weeks you said, well, they played Texas Tech or you know, they played Kansas and, you know, what's the big deal? Then you play a ranked Oklahoma State team where people thought it was going to be a lot closer, low scoring, and then Oklahoma wins by 4 touchdowns. Dominated that game. Even when it was 2 touchdowns and it looked like Oklahoma State at any moment could get back in the game, that Oklahoma defense was more potent and leaned on Oklahoma State more than the opposite. And Oklahoma State's got a decent defense. They're pretty good. But OU has 2 games left, West Virginia and Baylor. Assuming nothing happens with COVID, you know, knock on wood and all that. If they keep playing the way they're playing, they're going to be part of the conversation. It's true. It is happening right now. They're going to be part of the conversation. Did they talk about them a lot tonight? No. But being 11th, 4 weeks out, with a bunch of teams above you that are more than likely going to have to lose if the top three or four stays pretty much the same, OU is going to be in that pool of teams with a shot to get in the playoff once again. And I'll say this one last thing. I know there are OU fans out there who don't want to make the playoff. You know, you see this team and you don't want to lose again. You don't want to do this. Listen, I'm not going to make fun of you, all right? But I'm a fan. Like, if there's a chance to go play for a championship, I want it. I want to take it. And I'm not going to be, and if we don't get there, fine. I'm not going to be upset. We lost two games. Our argument is not as strong as it's been in years past. I admit that up front. I'm just saying there is a legit path to get here if a couple things go our way. We had to have a couple things go our way last year. We needed Oregon to drop a game to Arizona State, and it happened. But it's there, guys. I'm telling you. Like, even if it's like 5 or 6, there's going to be a week and a few weeks where if things keep going, we're going to be up in that 5 or 6 range. There's no guarantee all these, like, there's a lot of teams up there that are not used to being up in the top 10. Who knows how long they're going to stay there? Cincinnati might have to beat Tulsa twice. Even if they split that and, like, they lose 1 week and they win the championship, like, may not matter. One loss to Cincinnati is devastating. They will be done. The committee will have nothing to do with a Group of Five team. If you're a Group of Five, you have to be undefeated. Period. Cincinnati drops any games ever, they're done. And even then, it might come down to undefeated Cincinnati and 2-loss Oklahoma. And we will finally have that debate, what is more valuable, a 2-loss Power 5 champion or an undefeated Group of 5? We might be having that discussion in a few weeks, but that's a long ways off. For right now, if you're Oklahoma and you're Lincoln Riley and that team, you are very happy with being number 11 right now. And if you're Oklahoma, going to Morgantown, keep playing the way you're playing, whoop up on some teams, whoop up on West Virginia, come back home and beat Baylor for your final home game and get in that Big 12 championship. And if it's Texas, beat Texas again and beat them more convincingly. If it's Iowa State, you have an opportunity to right a wrong that took place at Ames. Because this is a different football team with just two different players. Much different football team. A more experienced football team and a more confident quarterback. So with that being said, Boomer Sooner, it's good to be an OU fan right now. Wait and see what happens. Worst case scenario, if OU wins out, we played a good New Year's Six game. So just embrace the race for the playoff. That's all I'm saying. Embrace it. There's nothing to be scared of, guys. I want to compete for championships. All of you should, too. We used to do that once in a while. So let's have some fun. Y'all have a good one. I'm out.